Okay, hello everybody. Today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept RHS rule. Okay, we have seen a theorem related to this. Okay, now we will see some examples. Okay, then afterwards we have to solve examples from the given worksheets. Okay, so first problem is, if triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle such that AB is equal to AC and AD is an altitude from A on BC, prove that angle B is equal to C, AD bisects BC and AD bisects angle A. These three things we have to prove. Okay. Now see, figure is also given. Once again see, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC isosceles, AB is equal to AC. We can see from the figure. Then AD is an altitude. AD is an altitude. It is bisecting. It is perpendicular to the base BC, is an altitude from A on BC. It is not given bisected, that we have to prove, that we have to prove. But AD is perpendicular on BC. So both the angles, angle ADB and ADC are is equal to 90 degree. Okay. And what is given? Prove that angle B is equal to C. B equals to C, AD bisects, AD bisects means we have to prove BD is equal to CD. And third thing, AD bisects angle A means we have to prove BAD is equal to CAD. Okay. These three answers we will get after showing both the triangles congruent. Means if we are able to show triangle ADB and triangle ADC are congruent, then all the three answers we will get. Okay. We can write with the help of CPCT, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. So now we will think about triangle. So, in solution, in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, we have AB is equal to AC. First thing, angle ADB is equal to angle ADC, angle ADB and ADC, ADB and ADC is equal to 90 degree. Okay. Why? It is given. Okay. Second thing, AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. That is also given. Okay. Means AB and AC both are hypotenuse of both the triangles. Okay. And that are equal. And third thing is given, AD is equal to AD, because AD is the common side for both the triangles. AD is the common side for both the triangles. Okay. So, both angles are 90 degree. Hypotenuse are equal of the respective triangles and one side is common, is equal. So, that is enough information to show by RHS criterion both the triangles are congruent. Understood? What RHS criterion says? Both the angles should be 90 degree. Triangle should be right angle triangle. Then hypotenuse should be equal and one corresponding side should be equal, and that all the things are satisfying by this information. So we can say here triangle ABD congruent triangle ACD. Triangle ABD and ACD are congruent. Okay. So now we can say, that is first one, angle B is equal to angle C. Directly we can say angle B is equal to angle C. Angle B and angle C are the corresponding angles. So by CPCT we can say CPCT. Then second thing, AD bisects BC. So here we can say BD is equal to CD. BD and CD are the corresponding sides, okay, of both triangles. So here also we can say by CPCT. Okay, means what? BD is equal to CD. This is first thing, this is second. BD is equal to CD means we can say AD bisects BC. Okay, this is second explanation. And third one, AD bisects angle A. So we can say BAD is equal to CAD. Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. This is also CPCT and corresponding angles of congruent triangle. So by CPCT, so here we can say AD bisects angle A. Okay, so this was very simple explanation. Okay. Okay, see here our next problem is, if perpendiculars from any point within an angle on its arms are congruent, prove that it lies on the bisector of the angle. Okay, see here once again. If perpendiculars from any point within an angle, within means it is, suppose we will take one angle, okay, this is angle we have taken, okay, suppose a perpendicular drawn from any point within an angle, that point is suppose here, okay, so that point I am saying here M, okay, or here we can take P, M, any point we can take. Now triangle ABC, this is I am taking A, B, C, okay. If perpendiculars from any point within an angle, point P is within an angle ABC, okay, perpendicular drawn on AB and BC. So I am taking accordingly that, according to that, that is perpendicular, this is also perpendicular and this is also perpendicular, okay. On its arms, AB and BC are the arms of angle ABC, okay, are congruent, prove that it lies on the bisector of that angle, are congruent, okay, are congruent means this and this is equal. Then we have to prove that it lies on the bisector of that angle, it lies, means point P lies on the bisector of angle B, on the bisector of angle B, means suppose we will construct here bisector of angle B, then it will pass through the, it will pass through the point P, okay, means here in short what we need to show, suppose this I will say angle 1 and this angle 2, okay, see here, prove that it lies on the bisector of the, of that angle, so BP is the bisector of angle ABC, BP is the bisector of angle ABC or angle B also we can say, means here we need to show angle 1 and angle 2 are equal, okay. So for this we can think about these two triangles ABP and here we can take this M and this we can say N, okay, point A is on the arm but here actual point is M, triangle we can say BPM and BPN, two triangles, we will think about two triangles, that is in triangle BPM and triangle BPN, okay, we are going to think about these two triangles, this and this. If we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent, then we can say angle 1 and angle 2 are equal because corresponding angles, understood, and by CPCT we can say angle 1 and angle 2 are same and that is the answer of this example, okay. So now see here how we can prove, it is given that perpendicular means angles are 90 degree, so we will think about RHS criteria, okay, so both the triangles are right angle, so that I am taking here angle BMP, angle BMP is equal to angle BNP, BMP is equal to, both angles are equal because reason each 90 degree, each angle is 90 degree, understood. Now hypotenuse of both the triangles will be BP and BP is the common side for both the triangles, so obviously that is same, so I am taking here BP is equal to BP, okay, that is common hypo of both the triangles, understood. And one more thing they have told us, PM is equal to PN and PM is equal to PN, okay, so that is given. So according to the RHS criteria, angle, both triangles should be right angle triangle, hypotenuse should be equal and any one leg, pair of leg, understood, from both corresponding sides, corresponding triangles, so PM and PN are equal, so this is enough information, so with the help of these three things we can say triangle BPM congruent triangle BPN by RHS, okay.
Now triangles are congruent, so now we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangle. Okay, and what they are asking, prove that it lies on the bisector of that angle. So BP is the bisector of angle B, and point P lies on the BP. Understood? So this is the explanation of this question. Okay. See here, next problem is, in figure AD is perpendicular to CD. AD is perpendicular to CD. CB is perpendicular to CD. If AQ is equal to BP and DP is equal to CQ, prove that angle DAQ is equal to angle CBP. Okay, very simple problem. Once again, see what is given. AD is perpendicular to CD. Here it is perpendicular. Also, CB is perpendicular to CD. Second thing, what is given? AQ is equal to BP. AQ and BP are equal, means hypotenuse are equal. Okay, because this is right angle. This is also right angle. So opposite sides are hypotenuse, and both the hypotenuse are equal. Then we have to prove that also it is given DP is equal to CQ. DP and CQ are equal. Okay, and we have to prove that angle DAQ is equal to angle CBP. Okay, angle DAQ and CBP we can show very easily, but before that we need to show triangle ADQ and triangle BCP are equal. Okay, or congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, then by CPCT we can say angle A is equal to angle B, or DAQ is equal to CBP. But one more thing is there, that is, this is directly they have told us only DP is equal to CQ. Okay, but we can show PQ is the common part. Understood? And PQ, that we can write PQ plus DP is equal to PQ plus QC, because DP and QC part is same. DP and QC part is same. PQ is common part for DC. Understood? So now we can say PQ plus DP is equal to, we can write DQ. This will be DQ. Also PQ plus QC means what? PC. Okay, so this we will say first. Okay, and DQ is the side of triangle ADQ and PC is the side of triangle BCP. Okay, so now we will think about both the triangles. Triangle ADQ in triangle ADQ and triangle BCP. Okay, what is angle ADQ? Angle ADQ is equal to angle BCP. Why? Because each angle is 90 degree, because it is perpendicular, so 90 degree. So first thing we have, then second thing, AQ is equal to BP, because that is given. AQ is equal to BP, that is given. Okay, and this is DQ is equal to PC, that is from 1, this is here, we can give reason. So now both the triangles are right angle, hypotenuse are equal, and corresponding one pair of side is equal. So this is enough information to show by RHS criteria both the triangles are congruent. So directly we can see here, triangle ADQ congruent triangle BCP by RHS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then we can say angle A is equal to angle B by CPCT. Okay, angle A means what? Angle DAQ is equal to angle CBP. Okay, so easily we can show both the angles are same by CPCT. Okay, thank you.